Now, Cameron's Weather Roadshow on NBC 26.
Welcome back, everybody. We are live in Freedom, where it feels like high school football tonight. No doubt about it. We've got chilly conditions on tap for evening games, and we've got another cool day on the way for tomorrow. Here's a look at your 7-day temperature trend. We're going to see highs tomorrow once again in the 50s. We'll warm up into the 60s on Sunday. 50s return on Monday, and be a nice little warm-up as we head through next week with temperatures actually getting pretty close to 70 by Thursday afternoon. Right now, we are looking at temperatures that are still hanging out in the lower 50s across most of northeast Wisconsin, well below normal for this time of year. Our normal high is in the lower 60s. Currently, in the valley, we've got cloudy skies. It is 52 degrees here on College Avenue. Meanwhile, in Green Bay, it is cloudy and also 52 with northeast winds right around 5 to 10 miles per hour. All right, here's a look at your NEW Sports Showdown Game of the Week forecast. Between the Little Chute Mustangs and the Freedom Irish, we can expect crisp conditions. My mouth is actually starting to freeze up here a little bit. It is surprisingly cool outside. I haven't acclimated to these temperatures yet. Clouds mixing with a few stars, especially as the game goes on. Kickoff temperatures will be in the upper 40s. All right, the satellite picture shows high pressure in control of our weather today, but that area of high pressure was producing a lot of cold air that was coming in over the lakes, producing all these lake effect clouds we've been dealing with pretty much all day long. We even had a few sprinkles as well, but we're going to turn up the spigot for tomorrow. And those sprinkles will become rain or showers on and off throughout the day on Saturday as our next weathermaker approaches from the west. You can see rain now spreading out into parts of Iowa, Kansas, and Missouri. And that area of rain is going to blossom as we progress through the night as it makes its way towards the state of Wisconsin. You can see it really coming together here across Minnesota and Iowa during the early morning hours. And then tomorrow, cloudy skies with periods of rain and or showers. That activity will continue right into the evening hours. Now, as far as precipitation totals are concerned, this is going to be nowhere near what we saw earlier in the week, but many spots will still pick up a quarter to a half an inch of rain with some locally higher amounts possible, especially north and west of the Fox Valley. Now, with the clouds and rain in the forecast and an easterly wind, temperatures once again tomorrow will be below normal. It'll be the fourth straight day with highs only in the 50s, but on Sunday we'll see sunshine. Temperatures will warm into the lower and mid 60s, so if you're not going to be checking out the Packers in Dallas, maybe you'll want to think about checking out some of the beautiful colors that we're now seeing across much of central and northern Wisconsin. Peak conditions across the Northwoods. Here in the Fox Valley, we still have about 2 weeks to go until we reach peak. So tonight, lots of clouds and a few stars. Overnight lows will be in the 40s. Tomorrow, cloudy skies with periods of rain and showers. High temperatures only in the 50s. My 3-degree guarantee for tomorrow is 56. If I can hit that high within 3 degrees, we will donate $100 to Shop with a Cop. And we did that today. I forecast 55. The actual high temperature was 52 degrees. On Sunday, the better of the two weekend days, no doubt about it. We'll see mostly sunny skies, some gusty winds. Highs will be in the lower to mid 60s. Maybe an early morning shower on Monday, then mostly sunny. Lower 60s here on Tuesday. And then we'll continue to warm up here for Wednesday and Thursday with gusty southerly winds before a strong cold front moves through Friday morning. Morning highs in the lower 50s and then falling into the 40s during the afternoon and maybe the 30s for Friday night lights next week. All right, I am now joined by Ted Stefaniak. He is one of the hosts of the My New 32 Sports Showdown Game of the Week here. And Ted, you're freezing already.
It is cold. I can't believe how cold it is. We were sweating a couple weeks ago, but I guess fall football weather is here.
Yeah, I said earlier that I can't see my breath, but I feel like I should.
Yeah.
It's pretty chilly.
Definitely. I brought an extra jacket, an extra layer, just in case I needed it later.
Yeah.
I've already put it on. It's that cold right now.
So, all right,
bring a blanket tonight.
Yeah, good idea. We got the battle of County Highway N tonight going
on? The sign, they have a county road sign N.
Okay.
And right now, Little Chute owns that because they won the game last year, so hopefully they bring it tonight. Freedom would like to get it back.
Yeah.
Freedom is 6-0 on the season this year. Little Chute is 4-2. So, you know, throughout the records, I guess, they want that County Highway sign.
It's going to be a good game, and where can people watch it?
Over on WACY, New 32. Our coverage starts at 6:30, kickoff at 7 o'clock. Hope you can join us.
All right, Ted. You can stay warm at home and watch the game.
I'm going to climb up in the press box.
All right, sounds good. Back to you, Stacy.